baby. I control the rock. If the rap slow, I control the block. Yeah, I'm really it, and you nah. Got a couple coups, I can draw the top. I done made it, nigga. All these digits coming in, I'm saving for the bigger picture. No one day I need them, might as well get used to me. My biggest fear is ending up a used to be. Yeah, yeah, my dad was TV. Damn, I see us on TV, unless it's the news. I got something to prove. Yeah, I'm young, but I got something to lose.
Welcome to the Bet the Garage podcast. I'm D Money along with my boy Kid Creole, ready to break down college football week two. What up, Kid?
I'm good, man. You're
finally out of that witness protection program after that LSU pick on Sunday night, huh?
Yeah, I appreciate you taking me back on the show because if not, you would have had to call my cousin Kid Gumbo. And
what happened to your hair?
I was on the run.
Oh, this is a disguise.
Yeah, okay. I mean, I had to. You know, I said, trim me up. Well, let me get out of town.
All right. So when undercover with little haircut. All right.
He's well, week one's
in the books. Overall, I went 7-4, but I was 5-1 on my best bets. You finished 4-6, but you were 4-1 on your best bets. Not a bad start.
So next time I finish 4-6, can we not mention it and just tell them about my best?
You're 4-1. Yeah, I guess we could do that. What were some of your takeaways from week one?
Vanderbilt, 2-0. I mean, one more game, I'll get the total wins over this year, which is 2.5.
Looks like you were right on that one.
I hope I like it. I mean,
yeah, you said it on the SEC preview show. That was one of your best bets.
I mean, 2.5. I mean, that's kind of low, and the coach is talking a lot of.
Any other takeaways you had from week one?
Georgia Bulldogs, are defense is still nasty. I mean, it's amazing. It's SEC defense. I mean, I was like, the defense, SEC, but look at that ass.
Yeah, their defense is definitely badass. They're probably still the best defense in the country. I'm probably going to regret that under 10.5 for Georgia because their defense really looks pretty good. For me, Cincinnati stood out. They're still, I know they lost to Arkansas, but they're still a good team. Bama was Bama. Florida State looks like they had, I know Florida State, you don't want to hear about Florida State right now, but looks like
they little quarterback surprised me. Look real good.
Looks like they
LSU found. First half was a tough game. I think, I'm really, I'm thinking Brian Kelly, did you maybe get the kick out there and then kick some balls and practice a little bit.
He didn't even get the kick off, but it looks like Florida State found the replacement for Jermaine Johnson in that Jared Verse coming over from Albany College because he took over the game at times. He was putting constant pressure on Jaden Daniels. And then this one's probably going to surprise you, but Clemson, I think they might still have a problem on offense. DJU might not be the answer there at quarterback. I know they scored 41 points, so it might sound a little ridiculous, but the offensive line sucked at times. DJU sucked at times, so I guess we'll find out if they get any better.
You know what? Let's week one is over. Let's just move on to week two.
Where do you want to start? Just that Saturday breakdown.
I got to start with the Commodores. I mean,
Vanderbilt. Yep, 2-0.
I mean, 2-0. I mean, I like the 13.5 points. I mean, it jumped a lot this week because Wake Forest's quarterback is going to return. But still, I got to take the points.
Yeah, I haven't been on that Vanderbilt train with you, but I do agree. Dan, you've been paying attention because Vanderbilt can run the ball against Wake, and I think Mike Wright, the quarterback, can make a couple plays, make that Wake defense pay. I like Vanderbilt plus the 13.5 too. Let's move on to Bama, Texas. A lot of hype around this game. Bama's minus 20.5, over under 64.5. Last week, Bama was Bama on defense. That defense looked like they were on a mission. Bryce Young did what he does, rushed for 100 yards. Gibbs added 93 yards rushing at a 55-0 beatdown of Utah State. Texas laid their own beatdown, though. They beat ULM Monroe 52-10. The offense was efficient. Ewers was 16 of 25 for 225, two touchdowns and an interception. Bijan Robinson added in 71 yards. Defense was decent, but this is a different ball game here. Talk to me, Kid. Do you think Texas has any shot of winning this game?
I have a better chance of winning the Powerball tomorrow night.
Yeah. That'd be nice if you won the Powerball.
I mean, I like Bama first half. I lay the points first half. Right now, since at 11 and a half. For the whole game, it's 20 and a half. I lay it first half. I lay it for the game. I just throw all money all on that.
Yeah, but I can tell you that...
I mean, Texas will score, but I don't see them scoring more than 14 points.
Yeah. I can tell you that I won't be on Bama the first half. I do think the stadium's going to be rocking early. I think that could keep Texas in the game. But I don't think that lasts long. I'll be looking to see what the line looks like for the second half in that Bama game. But I do think they'll cover the 20 and a half, so I'll probably be on that. Make sure you're following us on TikTok for those added picks, those second half picks. Let's move on to South Carolina, Arkansas. Arkansas minus 8.5, over under 52.5. A nice win against a good Cincinnati team for Arkansas last week. The Gamecocks beat Georgia State 35-14 despite Spencer Rattler struggling at times, throwing two interceptions. I picked Arkansas over 7.5 during the SEC preview show. I love KJ Jefferson. For me, this looks like a 10-point win for Arkansas, so I'll definitely be on that. Any thoughts on Arkansas and the Gamecocks?
That was a quality win for Arkansas. They should score against South Carolina. And Rattler, you know, he'd be able to hit some big plays. I mean, give me the over 52.5. I like the over in that game.
Your first over of the week. I know you want to talk Notre Dame-Marshall, so go ahead. Do you think Notre Dame's going to have a little hangover after that Ohio State game?
I think Notre Dame's a good team. I really like them. I mean, it's what's not to like about them. I mean, you know, they covered for us against Ohio State. I hate to say that. I know your ball's
playing
on that one. But.
Ohio State won the game, so that's all that counts.
Yeah, I mean, but we bet, so who really won? To me, Notre Dame won. I was getting
Okay. Well, last week I really didn't know what to expect from Notre Dame. I thought Ohio State would dominate them, and I thought Notre Dame could get a late score to stay within that 17 points. But Notre Dame really showed me something. Marshall, they covered a 40-point spread against Norfolk State last week. But this Notre Dame team is not Norfolk State, I can tell you that. I think this team is good enough to run the table, this Notre Dame team. Let's talk about one of the big games this week, Tennessee. -6.5 point favorites at Pitt. Total sits at 66.5. Tennessee didn't really have to try hard against Ball State. Hendon Hooker was as impressive as he needed to be in putting up 59 points. On the other side, I think Pitt got a little bit lucky, especially with that Bryce Ford Wheaton really tipping that ball to the Pitt defender, and it ended up being a pick six there. West Virginia was able to make plays. I think that Hendon Hooker is going to tear this secondary apart. I think they'll light it up. I'm not going to take the 6.5 points as a road favorite. I don't really like it at -6.5. I do like Tennessee over 37.5 points, and I like the over 66.5 for the game. Any thoughts on Tennessee Pitt?
It's just going to go back and forth. I mean, I like the over.
No. Second over. Two overs in a row for you.
I mean, I probably do bet more overs than unders. It's rare I bet unders.
Yeah, you never bet unders.
But if I'm going to bet under, I use it when I watch the game, really.
All right.
That's just me. It's like negative. Like,
you know, yeah, it's like second over. Let's see how many overs you get.
It's like betting on the...
We get to here.
Dope line and the craps table. You know, you want to bet on the line. You don't want to bet on the dope bet line. It's like negative.
Real quick, App State at A&M. A&M -18.5. Over under 53.5. A&M started off slow last week, but did get a 31-0 win. App State put up 61 in a loss to North Carolina, a wild game. Texas A&M has Miami up next week, so I don't know if they'll be looking ahead in this game. I do think they'll put up some points early and rest some players late. Maybe App State can score late against third stringers or something. What do you think about this game?
61 and a loss to North Carolina. They're not going to put up 61 points this week.
Yeah. No, they definitely won't put up 61 against A&M.
What do you like, man?
Because they're definitely not putting up 61 against A&M.
61 points.
Do you like the over-under in this game? 53.5?
What do you think I'm going to say?
I'm going to guess you're going to go over.
I'm going over this game.
Yeah. That's third over. Third over in a row. Let's talk about a matchup between two ranked teams, number 20, Kentucky. What happened?
I'm like counting them. Should we like make it like the marks on the...
I'll keep tally of your overs. Let's talk about number 20, Kentucky, at number 12, Florida. Last week, Florida wasn't ranked. Were able to put up 283 yards, sorry, against the tough Utah defense. But they did need a late interception in the end zone to preserve that win. Kentucky beat Miami of Ohio 37-13. Levis threw for 303 yards, 3 touchdowns. They did struggle to rush the ball, only rushing for 50 yards. For me, this is a tough one. I think Florida will be able to run, and I think Levis will be able to tear apart that Florida secondary. Sounds like an over to me, but 4 of the last 5 have been under. So, tough one for me, kid. Anything on Florida, Kentucky?
I like Florida laying the points. You get a number 20 against the number 17, but they're playing in Florida. I'll take Florida laying the points.
Florida minus the 5.5.
You know, I mean...
Go ahead.
I mean, I talked this garbage. I said, it's just hard to play in Gainesville.
Yeah, it is hard. It is a tough place to play. Utah learned that last week. The primetime game on ABC this week, USC minus 7.5, over-under versus standards, Stanford 66.5. This might pit the two best quarterbacks in the Pac-12 with Caleb Williams and Tanner McKee. Williams was 19 of 22, 249 yards, 2 touchdowns last week, and a 66-14 win over Rice. McKee went 22 of 27 for 308 yards, 2 touchdowns, and an interception, and a 41-10 win over Colgate. So we don't really know, we didn't really learn much from those two games. Last year they put up 70 in a Stanford 42-28 win. I think this is a similar game. I think USC wins this game 45-31. So I know it's a high total at 66.5. I like it. A kid, I would imagine you like the over here too.
They're going to throw the ball up and down the field, left and right. Everything is going to score some points. I do like the over. I mean,
that's 4.
I mean, maybe I won't pick any more overs for the rest of the night, but I do like the over. These quarterbacks can just throw the ball up and down the field. Not much defense there, so it's going to be a...
All right.
Yeah, you talking about last week.
I like the over, so I'm glad you like it, too. Last game, the late night game, which really is going to be worth staying up for. Number 9, Baylor at number 21, BYU. BYU minus 3.5, over under 53.5. Both teams with blowout wins last week. They did play last year at Waco. Baylor winning that game 38-24. Baylor rushed for 303. BYU rushed for 340, passed for 342. I think Baylor will be a little bit more balanced with Blake Shapen at quarterback. But I do like Baylor plus the 3.5. I'll be putting a little money on that money line too.
I have no interest in this game.
Should be a fun game, a close game. No interest.
I'm not even going to touch that game right there. That's just a tough call there.
All right. So before we wrap it up, you guys already know we love college football Saturdays, but we do watch NFL on Sundays. Last night, the NFL kicked off their season. The Bills went into the defending Super Bowl champions home, the Rams, and as 2.5-point favorites, really dominated that game 31-10. You were on the Bills minus the 2.5. I was on the cup over 91.5 yards.
That was nice. Man, Cooper Kupp must have slept like a baby last night because they were throwing the ball out. They were wearing him out, man.
Yeah, they were. He was wearing
him
out.
Odell Beckham in the stands. Cooper Kupp was like...
That's his boy, Cooper Kupp.
Jesus Christ.
Nice start for us for that NFL season, 2-0. Are you ready for this NFL season?
I'm ready. What do we do on Saturdays and Sundays? We watch football. You know, we watch college football for like 12 hours. NFL, we do watch it a lot, too.
We do.
But not as much as college because, you know, the games are all night. You can watch it till like 1 in the morning.
All right, kid, we covered a lot of games today. Let's get the best bets for Saturday. Who do you like?
Another game?
Oh.
Is that Parlay Princess?
Parlay Princess mentioned who I like.
I'm here. I like Notre Dame. That's all I got to say.
Okay. Notre Dame.
Well, thank you for my answer. But I do like Notre Dame, and I do like Vanderbilt. Mm-hmm. That's my two teams. I The other games, I'm just going to wait, watch, and enjoy. I do like a lot of overs today. But my two picks for tomorrow, my best bets.
Vanderbilt plus the 13.5 and Notre Dame minus the 20.5.
20.5
for the game, yeah. I'm going to be looking to take Bama in, probably second half, if it makes sense. I'll probably be on Bama minus the 20.5. I will be on Baylor plus 3.5. USC over 66.
Take Alabama first half.
I don't,
you don't know where you're going to sit the guys these days. You don't know.
Nah.
You get fourth quarter.
I'm going to bet the game, and I'm going to see. I'm not going to bet the first half. I'm going to wait to see what happens.
Well, you made it. Okay, I don't want to.
I think that place is going to be rocking. That, you know, might be a slow start for Alabama there. But my three best bets, I actually have three. Tennessee over 37.5. I think they put up 40 against Pitt. I'm going to go with Arkansas minus the 8.5. And we didn't talk about this game. Mississippi State at Arizona over 60.5. Will Rogers threw for 450 yards, 5 touchdowns last week. I think he could do it again against this Arizona team. So I like that as one of my best bets there. That's our show for college football week 2. You can listen to us on Spotify, iTunes. Make sure you're following us on Twitter, TikTok, Instagram. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Bet the Garage. Why don't you take us home, kid? Don't tell me you forgot the line.
I got it, but Jesus Christ, that was nice.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate
the way you roll that off.
You're trying to think of the closing?
No, I know it.
You know it?
Right, let's see. Well, I wasn't going to take this home. I was going to tell them to tune in tomorrow and TikTok.
Oh, yes.
And we'll give them some picks.
Good call. Remind them. Yep.
You know, during the day, maybe some games that we missed today, and especially NFL. But always, remember, don't bet the house, bet the garage.
Peace.